Bro, that's nice of you to go around, well, so that we can see you. Great of you to come over at such short notice. And you obviously still fit into all those clothes from 20-odd years ago.
Yeah, actually, I'm glad I fit in them, I guess. I don't know, it's just something, maybe I was too fat when I raced, I'm not sure. But I just love the chance to come over here and to see the famed Farley Castle racetrack, for one. And to come over and see a lot of the people that I used to race with, I mean, from David Thorpe to Johnny O'Mara and these guys, there's so much tradition here, and I'm all about the tradition and history of the sport. Even when I was a young child, I remember watching Herbert win a moto at Carlsbad Grand Prix as a child, younger man, but it's just great for me to be able to be here, and I couldn't be happier in this event. It exceeded all my expectations, actually.
Well, it's the fact that people like you come over that helps it to exceed those expectations, I think. You obviously rode most of your career on Yamaha. You won 3 125 American Championships, 3 500, so you were another great all-rounder because you had great success on the 250 as well. But you also finished off your career, that's people sometimes forget, on a 250 KTM, working for the factory in 1989 and won the last race of the season in Belgium.
Yeah, I mean, I was kind of fortunate. My last race I ever rode in the U.S. In a supercross race to Yamaha, I was able to win. I got lucky there and won a race there, and then I won my last moto I ever rode on a Grand Prix, too. So it's kind of fun to be able to at least say that in my career, that I finished off on a high note. But yeah, the year 1989, actually, was fun because Rodney Smith and I spent the whole year on the Grand Prix circuit. And it was really a developmental year, and KTM had kind of hired me to help develop a new modern motorcycle that they felt was effective in the U.S. market. They were trying to break into the U.S. market and sell bikes in the States. And so, I just wanted to know that I went out of my career and actually got to ride some Grand Prix, because when I was a young child, I used to look at all the magazines and see all the famous European riders, see all the Grand Prix tracks. And I would literally drive around Europe sometimes on a way to another race and look on a map where an old famous track was, like Sittendorf or any of these tracks and Geldor, and go over there and just walk around them just to look at them and reminisce of what it used to be. So finally I get to see Farley Castle now.
It's absolutely brilliant to have you here. Many thanks for coming. Brock Lover, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks, Brock.